What is this constraint? Okay, what is the constraint motion? Okay, constraint means bounded. Okay, bounded through some laws. So though the motion which is bounded through certain laws, that is known as constraint motion. Now here, if I talk about this constraint motion, so there are different types of the constraint. Okay, the first constraint is the length constraint. Okay, the first one which we study, that is the length constraint. Again, I'm repeating, it is length constraint, right? Now, in length constraint, the length of the string or length of the rod or whatever substance is there, that length of the substance will be constant during the motion. Okay, so in length constraint, length of either we say string, right, or we say rope, or we say a rod, right, will be constant during its motion. Okay, so that is length constraint. Now let me give you one idea so that you can easily get this, right? So I'm drawing here one figure, so with the help of that you will be able to understand the length constraint. Let's say this is a pulley. Everyone I think knows about the pulley. Anyone who doesn't know about the pulley, let me explain you then regarding that pulley. Everyone knows about the pulley?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
now,
sir.
Over here, let's say this pulley that has three ends here right now, okay? So, out of those three ends, the two ends of the pulleys, they are free. Okay, two ends of the pulleys that I am saying is free and one end is fixed. Okay, I think I have to make it manually. It is not getting like that. Okay, doesn't matter. So this is one end of the pulley and this is second end of the pulley. It means a rope or a string is just wound on it like this. And one of the end of the pulley is fixed. Okay, this end is fixed. Now if I say, if I am pulling it from the right side by displacement x. So if it is displaced by x, this much amount is x. Okay, so can I consider the same amount of the displacement will be there in the opposite direction and that will be minus x. Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
बहुत सिंपल सी लैंग्वेज में समझो, ये जो आपका पुली का स्ट्रिंग है, ओके, द स्ट्रिंग ऑफ दिस पुली, ओके, इट्स लेंथ विल बी कांस्टेंट ड्यूरिंग इट्स मोशन, राइट, दैट इज लेंथ कंस्ट्रेंट. नाउ हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड द रिलेशन बिटवीन द वेलोसिटी एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग एंड वन बाय वन वी विल लुक अबाउट द different types of the cases. Okay, so I am here dealing with the first case. Okay, the first case. We will learn it through two different methods. One is just assumption and second one will be differentiation and you will enjoy both the methods. Okay, and you are not bound to use any one method. You can use any method anytime. So here I consider, suppose, case one. In the case one, all the three faces, out of three faces, one face means one end of the pulley is fixed. This is fixed. Okay. One end of the pulley is fixed. Now, let's say this much part of the pulley has length x1 and this much part of and this much part of the pulley has length x2. Let the radius of the pulley is r right? So this semicircular part length of the string will be pi r. Now, see very, very carefully. Can I say the x1 plus x2 plus pi r, that is equal to length of the string, which will be constant? Yes or no, students, tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If I differentiate it with respect to time, see carefully. Dx1 upon dt plus dx2 upon dt plus radius and pi are constant, differentiation of constant term with respect to time is zero. Same length is constant, differentiation will be
zero.
Zero. Can I say v1 plus v2 is equal to zero? Correct?
Yes, sir.
And v2 vector is equal to minus v1 vector.
V1
vector is equal to minus v1 vector means, if suppose if I consider that this part, left part of the pulley is coming down, okay, so the right part of the pulley will move up,
going up,
okay, or vice versa. I can consider this situation also. If I consider the left part is moving up by displacement x1, so right part will come down,
move
with
down,
displacement x2. And same relation we can follow for the velocities. I hope everyone is clear regarding this. Tell me.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Again, if I differentiate with respect to time, what I will get? Dv1 upon dt plus dv2 upon dt. And that will be again zero. So this is acceleration of first
acceleration
part plus acceleration of
acceleration
second
part,
of
second
part equal
zero. Equals to zero.
And that is giving us the result a2 equals to minus a1.
A minus.
Okay. It means both the ends will have equal and opposite accelerations, right? So this was the first method, which was based on the differentiation. Okay, it is based on the differentiation, first method. Now, second method, I have already explained you, just I am giving you the idea again. See here. If I look at this part, okay, I am writing here M2, method 2. Okay, now if I am displacing it vertically downwards with y and this portion with displacement x, so what I will say, y will be equal to minus x. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Y will be equal to minus x. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now I will take always reference line for the second method, and that reference line will always pass through the midpoint of the pulley. Okay. Now here x, how I will get this result, always remember this thing, okay? With respect to this reference line, okay, reference line. If x is moving towards the reference line, will I say this length of the left part will decrease? Yes or no? If this left part that I am putting here 1 is moving towards the reference line, so will the length of this particular section which is hanging left side will decrease?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And it is decreasing, so I will say minus x. Now come to the right side. This portion is moving down. So can I say the second part, means right side of the length of the pulley, will increase with respect to this reference line? Yes or no?
Yes.
It is increasing, so
yes,
I will,
sir,
write plus. It is increasing, so I am writing plus. But all over, is there any change in the length of this string?
No, sir.
Tell me.
No change.
No, sir.
So
no.
I will put it like zero. Okay, I will put it zero. So the magnitude of y I am getting equal to magnitude of x. But if I go with the direction, I will say y is equal to minus x, or x equals to minus y. I hope both the methods are clear to everyone. Tell me. Okay. Now we are coming to the second case. Okay. The second case. What is case number 2? And see, until and unless we will do the questions, you have to memorize these cases, right? Even though we are trying our level best to understand this, but finally you have to use these directly. Okay. So now in this situation, again, let's say this pulley has 3 ends, right? Now out of 3 ends, 1 end is fixed, which is either right or left. Okay. This end is fixed. Now again, I'm coming to the point. Let's say the upper part, okay, that is coming down, right? And this is again a reference line. Reference line, okay? So this upper part I am saying is suppose X, okay? If it is X, what will happen? The new position of the string, sorry, the pulley. Can I say this will be the new position of the pulley? Tell me. After some time, so over here, what I was telling, if the upper portion of this string is coming down, right, upper portion is coming down with displacement X, right? So after some time, the new position of the pulley will be this one. This is the initial position, and now this is the new position. So displacement will be X in both the sides. Yes or no? Tell me, students.
Yes, sir.
So how it was more at left side?
It is fixed na, so there will be lag in that. It is coming down. ऐसा थोड़ी है कि left part नहीं आएगा, right आ जाएगा आगे नीचे. The whole part will come down.
Yes, sir.
So now if here the length is fixed, what will happen? There is no scope in the left side. The string can go down. So what will happen? This sag which is developed in the left part, that will also be stressed in the right portion. So all over sag, or you can say all over displacement in the string in right side will be 2x. Yes or no? Upper portion of this pulley is coming down with x. So this pulley that will move down, right? And this pulley is moving down in that situation. From both the sides, it will be displaced by X. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So there is no scope in the left side. This string cannot move down. Okay, it will not move down. So whatever the excess is there, that is only in the right side. So it will be displaced in the right side by 2X. One is already there. X is already there. And extra X will come from the left side because it is fixed. So now I hope you are clear with that. Tell me. Yes, tell me quickly.
Yes. Yes, sir, clear.
Okay. So this was the second case. Now third case we will discuss. For the third case, we will take all the 3 ends of the pulley free. Let's say this is the situation, right? And the 3 parts of the pulley, they are free. This one is free, first one. Then the second one is also free. And the third part is also free, okay? Now here you have to focus little bit with more concentration. Here, this is the reference line. Okay, this is reference line. Now let's say the upper part is coming down with Z, displacement Z. Okay, now tell me with respect to this reference line, this length of the string is increasing or decreasing? Tell me, will it increase or decrease?
What?
the length of the string here, this one, will increase or decrease with respect to reference line if the upper portion is coming down?
Decrease.
Nothing will happen.
Are it is, see, coming down with respect to reference line. Reference line will remain here only. The pulley will shift down. Okay. The pulley will shift down, but still, what is going to happen?
So, sir, in
yes.
Sir, in reference to the reference line, it will get less. It will get.
Yes. So, with respect to reference line, we can simply say it will be little bit less. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the point is that from both these sides, okay, from both these sides, the sag developed will be Z, or you can say displacement of the left hand and right hand of the pulley vertically downwards, that will be ZZ. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if suppose here a block is attached of the different mass and here the another block is attached of the different mass, maybe same, maybe different, but right now we are considering it is different. So if it is different in that situation, let's say the left part is coming down with Y and right part is moving up with X. Okay. So all over, can I say here Y is increasing with respect to reference line, X is decreasing with respect to reference line, and Z from both the sides, it is decreasing with respect to reference line. So all over it will be zero. Yes or no?
Sir, repeat this. I didn't get this.
Okay. Check it. Y, it is coming down. So with respect to reference line, the left part length of the string will increase. So I have written plus Y. Now X, if I talk about X, because right part of the string is coming up, so with respect to reference line, it is going to decrease. So I will write minus X. And here Z, see, with respect to this upper portion, it is down. Okay, it is down. So it is what? Minus 2Z from both the sides. Okay, so all over Y minus X equals to 2Z. Is this third case is clear to everyone? Tell me.
No, sir.
No. Okay. So let me take one more example. Let's say this is third situation again. Okay. And here I am drawing the reference line. I am considering this is moving up this time. So if it is moving up with respect to this reference line, can I say the Z will increase? Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes.
Now from both the sides, the displacement in the vertical up direction will be Z plus Z. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now let's consider from the left part, the string is going down by Y. So if a string is going down with respect to this reference line, can I say the length of this string of the left part will increase by Y? See, a block is attached.
Yes, sir.
Whether the pulley yes, is moving up or down, it doesn't matter. But if block is attached here, it is going to down. If it is going down, in that case, it will increase by Y. And the right side
yes,
will
got
move
it.
Up. Right
it
side
will
move up. So here, the X is going to decrease. The X is going to decrease with respect to reference line. So we will take minus X. So all over
yes.
plus Y minus X, you can write equal to either 2Z. Or you can write Y minus X minus 2Z equals to 0. Both are same. Okay.
Sir,
yes.
Sir, in this case, Z is going up with respect to reference line. So,
yes. So, we have taken. Just a minute. Yes, you are right here. Okay. The Z is moving up with respect to reference line. So we will take it plus 2Z. Okay. And Y is increasing, that is plus Y, but X is decreasing. So we will write minus X and all over 0. So you can say here the Y plus 2Z equals to X. Y plus 2Z equals to X. Okay. I hope everyone now is clear with this. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, competitive exams. So what is that question? See, let's say this is a pulley and the rope is attached with this pulley and it is like this. Instead of that, I will make it directly. It will be more better. So three pulleys they have given us. And these two pulleys which are at the ends, they are pulled down with the velocity u. And the middle one, it is moving up. These angles are given to us same, theta and theta, okay? So we have to find the velocity of this pulley, middle pulley V, in terms of U and theta, okay? So I will tell you two methods. The second method you will like the most, the first method is based on the mathematics. So to understand that, what I am doing here, I am taking this as length L and this distance, horizontal distance, I am taking X. This one is X and this vertical distance I am taking Y. Okay. Now the relation between these three according to Pythagoras theorem, can I say is X square plus Y square is equal to L square? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
X is the means you have taken from middle of the third pulley or
from top? here, this where it is touching.
Okay,
so now differentiating both the sides with respect to time. So can I say X will not change? X is constant. The pulley when it will move up, will the value of X change? No. So differentiation of X with respect to time, zero. Now Y will decrease as the pulley, middle pulley is moving up, the Y will decrease. So differentiation will be 2Y then dy by dt. Yes.
We need to find the velocity of middle pulley turning or middle pulley moving up.
The velocity of middle pulley which with which it is moving up.
Okay.
Now right side also length of the pulley is also decreasing here. Okay. So what we will say 2L dl by dt, differentiation of L square. 2 cancel both the sides. So it is Y then dy by dt is equal to L dl by dt. This is, let's say, second equation in method number one. Now, can I say Y is decreasing, so minus dy by dt equals to velocity V? Yes or no, students? Tell me quickly.
Sir, Y is moving up, that's why minus.
Yes, sir.
Y is decreasing now, as pulley is moving up, Y will decrease. Same way, this is first case of the pulley. Here it is coming with u down, so it will move up with the u. So L is decreasing with respect to time. So minus dl by dt equals to u, correct?
Yes, sir.
Putting yes, these sir. Two so values in the equation number. Pardon, beta?
How do we take that minus dy by dt?
See, pulley is moving up, so Y is decreasing with respect to time or not? Tell me. Yes. Is it decreasing or not? Yes, beta, respond, otherwise how will I say?
Yes, sir.
So now dy by dt I am putting here minus v, dl by dt I am putting minus u, minus minus cancel. So v is equal to L times of u by y. Now from this triangle only, okay, from the triangle only, can I say the cos theta value, cos theta is equal to base, that is y, upon hypotenuse, that is L. So L by y, can I say is u upon
sec theta.
Cos theta, or u sec theta you can say.
Yes, sir, u sec theta.
Okay. I hope everyone is clear regarding this solution. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
First method. So okay, now second method I am telling you, which will give the answer in seconds. Okay. How come? Let me tell you. This length, okay, this length of the pulley is constant. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, just we will use the concept of vector. I am putting it here. This is V and this is U. Okay. This is V and this is U and this angle is theta. So if I take the component of V along this line, hypotenuse line, can I say V cos theta will be equal to U? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Sir, no, sir. Can you repeat?
Component, you have learned how to take the component, beta. Component, yes, of sir. V along this U will be what? V cos theta?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And this V cos theta is U. So directly see with the second method how fast you are getting result. Okay.
Sir, this is for this one side only, no?
Both the sides are identical. It will be same.
Sir, but both the sides are moving down, so velocity will be double, na?
So, dono taraf 2u hai, to 2u, and this will be 2v, 2 cancel.